260 pounds for Oumar Kane. 263.75 pounds for Jasur Mirzamukhamedov.
They dominated the third and pulled out the win. Look at this as they go arm to arm, nose to nose. Some bad blood between a couple of heavyweights. This will be the second fight on the card tomorrow night. Boy, these guys, they want to get it going here tonight in the Philippines. We cannot wait for these big boys.
Yeah, Brett, with really good reason. These guys are expecting to really start to bring it. And I want to see what kind of improvements Reug Reug has made. He got a new camp out there in Dubai, and he's got a really strong team with John Milano in his corner right now. And let's see what kind of style he brings to this match tonight against a dangerous striker like Mirzamukhamedov.
Dangerous. Going up top of the left early on, first shot of the night from Khan. Reug Reug, outside leg kick, then took a jab.
And the wrestler looks comfortable throwing strikes from Jasur.
He doesn't just take people down, Reug Reug. He slams them to the canvas and then wails away on him. He can just bulldoze guys. Explodes out of nowhere at any moment.
If Reug Reug is going to continue standing, threatening that shot like that, it'll keep Jasur at bay. But if he's going to continue standing, Jasur would be wise to kind of, and there we go.
There's the takedown from Reug Reug.
Nice takedown. Easily passes, but Jasur does a good job of getting his left leg in and preventing. There he is using that butterfly hook with his left leg to elevate the leg of Reug Reug just to prevent the mount. And looks like Oumar Khan's going to settle into half guard here.
Yeah, we've seen him, Jasur, he's actually quite flexible for someone that size. You know, we've seen him in previous matches working like rubber guards and his butterfly guard, making things quite difficult for the people on top of him.
Mirzamukhamedov, a professional record of 6-0 with 4 finishes. This is second fight in one. He is 1-0 to start.
Oumar Khan's doing a good job of flattening out Mirzamukhamedov, right? So Mirzamukhamedov needs to get onto his side, right? He needs to turn his body, get an underhook with his left arm, and then start to work his way onto his side so he can get away from this. As long as Reug Reug is able to flatten him out and keep him flat on the mat like this with both shoulders pinned to the ground, he's going to have a lot better time controlling him and also dropping ground and pound.
Two minutes in to this first round. 3 5-minute rounds. Again, the bout judged as a whole in the heavyweight division.
See, now Mirzamukhamedov has the lockdown, right? How he has Oumar Khan's leg kind of trapped there in the half guard, so he's not going to be able to advance. But Oumar Khan really likes the half guard position. He can just sit there and drop those big hammers on top.
Yeah, I don't look for Mirzamukhamedov to actually advance position or try to get up. When he had Duke on top of him, he was just basically clinching and holding and kind of forcing Herb here into a possible stand-up. That's what Jasur Mirzamukhamedov is looking for at this point.
It's a great look from our crew here in Manila.
We do a good job of scooting onto his right side, but with his hand just holding onto the head like that, there's really only one strategy, and that's to hold on to your opponent until the referee gets you up. He abandons that. Now he's starting to work from his guard a little bit, but he's putting himself in a dangerous position for the ground and pound. It looks like he's going after a leg right here.
A couple of shots on the way up from Reug Reug, but again, Mirzamukhamedov got a hold of that leg, and now Mirzamukhamedov comfortable just laying on his back here. And now Herteen welcomes him off, but some shots on the way up from Reug Reug.
Big wild strikes by Kane as he presses him against the wall here. Let's see if he tries to drop down.
This is the kind of strategy that Jasur needs to drag Reug Reug into, because him pressing against the fence like this, he's going to be using a lot of energy here. So Reug Reug either needs to get this clean takedown or break away, shake the arms out, relax a little bit, and be conservative with his striking.
Or you could just stall and wait for a separation.
There you go. Back to the center of the one circle. Second down of the night, the heavyweights. Mirzamukhamedov from Uzbekistan. And Oumar Khan, Reug Reug from Senegal.
Nice little duck under right there from Oumar Khan as he slipped underneath the punch, went to the body lock, and again puts Mirzamukhamedov onto his back.
Second takedown for Reug Reug in this opening round. 30 seconds to go. Looking to launch him with shots to the right.
Yeah, good defense right there from Mirzamukhamedov, just to get his feet onto the hips, push away a little bit, but he gives up the position, and Oumar is able to scramble into side control now. Let's see if Mirzamukhamedov can wall walk here and use the fence just to kind of reposition his legs and roll out the back.
Hammer fists on the way up from Oumar Kane. And again, firing shots to the head of Mirzamukhamedov.
Those hammer fists were coming down heavy, but Jasur did a good job of not taking much damage in that position right there. Something I used to do in between rounds, take those deep breaths, or if he's really already had the gas tank tested that much.
Well, that's a lot of muscle to be carrying around the circle for 5 minutes. So he was definitely breathing heavy, and he, you know, seemed, you know, a little bit anxious, but his coaches were trying to get him to calm down. Coach Milano was telling him to slow his breath down, get his energy back, because shooting these takedowns like this is exhausting.
What did you tell us in the opening, Rich? 500 and what pounds of beef?
Over 520 pounds of beef in the ring here tonight. So even though you're looking at Reug Reug's frame and he's strong, Jasur's a big man. Like, that's a lot of weight to carry when you're coming underneath him. He's throwing on top of you. Jasur would be wise here to start letting these hands go, though.
I don't mind the leg kicks, though. I like the way he keeps touching the legs, but because when he lets the hands go, he's kind of overextending, and he's letting Reug Reug kind of slip underneath, pull these takedowns and put him down like this.
Firing rights is Reug Reug with his third takedown of this bout.
You know, but Mirzamukhamedov told us this week that he was like, I'm just going to let this guy gas himself out. I think he's going to fade, and I'm going to be able to take advantage just like I did in my last match and really start to work, you know, my game into this matchup. But, you know, we don't want to really let time, you know, go by so much, especially with a guy like Reug Reug on top of you.
When Jasur was fighting Duke Didier, in that match, you know, had Duke just taken his foot off the gas in that third round and not pressed, Jasur would have lost that match. And so that's what he's got to be careful of here, because even if Reug Reug gets tired and he doesn't present the opening in the third round, it might be difficult to overcome that 10-minute deficit.
How compromising is this position right now for Mirzamukhamedov?
Well, I mean, it really depends on how much training he's been doing out there in Dagestan, working on his guard. You can see he kind of went to, you know, maybe threaten a rubber guard or mission control, where he actually brings his leg up on top just to get a little bit better control. But it's just a stalling technique at this point. He's trying to grab the head, you know, stop the ground and pound that's coming down from Reug Reug.
We are in Manila, the Philippines, here tonight. Second bout of the night. The heavyweights, Mirzamukhamedov and Oumar Kane. Brent Stover, Mitch Chilson, Rich Ace Franklin, the Hall of Famer. Bout 2 of 4 on the lead card. 10 p.m. Eastern, exclusively on Prime Video. The main card, and we've got 2 world title fights on tap.
Yeah, you know, to Mitch's point here, I'll just say this. It's rare that you see heavyweights on their back that are this limber. You know, Jasur does a good job. Sometimes you see him working rubber guard, butterfly guards. This is kind of a rare thing. He's very comfortable on his back, but he's also not active. He'll keep the damage from coming in, but he's not doing anything offensively and not really scoring there either. So in that case, you know, with Reug Reug being on top, whether the occasional punch lands or not, he's taking a slight lead, if nothing else.
Oh, but look, it's working, right? He's holding on that position so that Herb Dean stands him up, and it's worked to his benefit each time, but now he's getting lit up as Reug Reug starts to push forward, looking for the takedown again. Let's see if Mirzamukhamedov can dig some underhooks. Looks like he's grabbing the shorts there a little bit.
One of those patented one-arm throwdowns from Reug Reug that time.
Man, that right cross that just landed on Reug Reug there had Reug Reug checking the light structure above us.
Come on, let's work. Knee, stump.
80 seconds here in round 2. Herb Dean taking a close look. Mirzamukhamedov with his back against the fence.
Yeah, Mirzamukhamedov was complaining to Herb Dean that Oumar Kane was grabbing his shorts. So looks like Oumar has let go of that, and he breaks it again. See, it's a great stalling technique, and he knows, maybe Mirzamukhamedov knows that Herb Dean is a referee that encourages action, and he'll actually use this to his advantage.
Now I'm looking at Reug Reug's posture, and you can see that he just looked deflated as he walked away from that last one. He's still a threat for the takedown, but you can just tell that the takedowns do not have that same explosiveness that they had in the first minute of this match.
He does a good job of ducking under, right? He waits for the punches to come, slides right underneath, but he just just can't finish the takedown. He's pressing him here, but this is what Mirzamukhamedov does so well. We saw it last time. He's able to drain your gas tank and then put it on you.
Keep breathing, Oumar. Keep breathing.
Is this still the right strategy for Oumar Kane? Is he going to need to change things in the final round?
I think these guys need to just go at it. I think they need to throw caution to the wind and just start throwing paws at each other because
I think after Oumar had a taste of that last cross that Jasur hit him with, his strategy about throwing strikes has completely gone out the window. He's going to close the distance, stay here, and try to conserve as much energy as possible.
You know from experience, huh?
Well, now you can take a look at the body language.
Yeah, I've known from experience because I've hit many people with that cross. Mitt's so big. Keep your feet underneath you. Make it difficult to take you down. Just peppering Oumar Kane with these punches will score you a victory.
Well, definitely at this point, Reug Reug is ahead of the judges' scorecards. Has to be, just for the takedowns, top control, and really just sort of putting this match where he wants it. Just like this, right? Nice little takedown, waits for the timing. To your point, you know, he needs to kind of tighten up those punches a little bit, does Mirzamukhamedov, but Oumar Kane, beautiful duck under there, able to get this match where he wants. And when you spend your entire life wrestling, these types of positions and this type of stuff on top is not that energy taxing.
Oumar Kane emerging from humble beginnings in a small fishing village just outside of the Senegalese capital of Dakar, and now he is the nation's biggest combat sports star with that wrestling background that you talked about. And listen, going back to the beginning of the match, Dragon, and you touched on it, he's really starting to put it all together in terms of technique and things of that magnitude.
Yeah, you know, he's definitely getting better, but he's leaning on his strength and he's taking, you know, Mirzamukhamedov where in his weakness, right? He's taking him down, putting him where he doesn't want to be, making him work off his back, and getting this match and putting it exactly where he wants. And that's right here, on top, dropping ground and pound. You know, he's not only trying to pass, you know, he's not trying to advance his position, he's not trying to pass the guard, you know, he's just trying to hold Mirzamukhamedov down and drop ground and pound, score points.
You know, we talk about him switching camps and working on his stand-up game, but it would behoove him at this point in time, like, if he was actually just guard passing to the point where he could get to the half guard, it would be easier for him to start accumulating some real damage from the ground here. It's just difficult when you're in the guard oftentimes with that ground and pound to really do damage, particularly with someone like Jasur. You can see that Jasur is doing a good job of tying up, like, you know, stopping the arm here, not really taking any real damage with anything. He's comfortable pulling his leg over. Like, this is rare for heavyweights. And so if Oumar Kane was just able to pass the guard, it would be easier for him to win definitively.
So we feel like Reug Reug is on top of the scorecard because of the takedowns. So what can Mirzamukhamedov do here in the final 2.5 minutes?
Well, I'll just say this. He's ahead on the scorecards with the takedowns, but keep in mind that when you take someone down, you score in the takedown category. You're not scoring in the grappling division there. Like, he's not improving his position. Once he hits the ground, he needs to either improve his position or do some damage, and he's not really doing either.
See, we know that, you know, Oumar is going to shoot underneath these punches. I would love to see Mirzamukhamedov throw a knee down the middle or just start using some straight line weapons. That uppercut worked beautifully in the second. I want to see more of these here in the third. Fake it. Fake that big overhand right that it's coming, and then throw that knee right up the middle.
2 minutes to go in the fight.
Yeah, Jasur should be feinting this jab right now. And he needs to be aggressive, but aggressive doesn't mean he needs to move forward recklessly, because Oumar is just going to dip underneath those punches and take him back down and you know, win this on control. But man, Jasur needs to really, really move with a sense of urgency here.
Left hook from Kane, saw that shot a moment ago as well. Mirzamukhamedov snapping off a couple of jabs. 90 seconds in the fight. There's a straight right from Mirzamukhamedov. Kane counters to the left. And an outside leg kick. And shoots for the takedown and gets him on his back once again.
That was a nice double leg takedown. Beautifully executed. Didn't even need the punches. Basically just fake the shot once, came right under again, and easily put Mirzamukhamedov onto his back.
A minute to go.
Oumar's trying to pass into half. He might be trying to work his way into side control, but I think he's just gonna sit here, do a little bit of damage with the ground and pound. Good top control, good hand positioning. Right, driving his shoulder into the face, and then just beating up the body.
Effort.
Throwing shots to the back here of Mirzamukhamedov. Trying to wind up and get some power behind it, Oumar Kane.
He's got to be careful. Some of these strikes might actually end up being illegal if he's striking the spine.
30 seconds, Kane, trying to work the body. Tenderize the body of Jasur. Seconds to go in the fight.
10 seconds. Finish hard now. Let's go.
Kind of looking for a strong finish here, but also content with top position. Following another takedown. A couple of shots for good measure to close out the bout.
By unanimous decision, Uzbek.